So I recently got this question in the context of a broader email, and I thought it was really interesting. It says, "I'm sorry, but can you answer this one question as I'm freaking out about it? I mentioned being on Zoloft earlier and read that it can be a source of my memory loss along with the stress of dealing with my mom's dementia," which was what we were talking about in the email. "Since this drug is helping me, is it worth it to stay on the 100 milligrams, lessen the dosage, or get off it completely? Are the effects long-term and irreversible? Thank you so much." So I wanted to address this really common question. Do antidepressants, specifically SSRIs, contribute to memory loss or the development of dementia later on in life? I'll throw the TLDR up on the screen while I introduce myself in case you don't have time to get into all the details so you can get the facts there. But I'm Robert Duff, and the reason that I want to talk about this are actually two reasons. One, I'm a neuropsychologist. That means I focus on the brain, and I actually do testing of people's memories. So I have people that come in all the time and ask me questions like this: is this antidepressant going to cause me memory loss? Or they come in and just tell me, hey, I went off my antidepressant because I know it causes memory loss. Dr. Oz told me. The other reason that I really want to cover this is I've been on Lexapro or escitalopram for several years now. I'm on 10 milligrams. It works really great for me. So obviously, this is something I wanted to dive into the research for and make sure that I'm not at risk. So yeah, let's talk about it. I'm going to dive into the details a bit here, and I'll reference some research articles. These are peer-reviewed research studies. If you want the links to all of those, I'm going to put a link in the description that has an article that I wrote up about all of this. All the links are in there in the relevant section, so you can check all that out. So yeah, like I said, for this, I'm going to specifically focus on SSRIs, which are the most common form of antidepressant medication. There are many other types of antidepressants, and the information that I'm giving you here may not apply equally to all of them. So please make sure that you ask your doctor, you do your own research about this, making sure you look at peer-reviewed studies, not just whoever is on TV or whoever is, on social media talking about this stuff. But for SSRIs, this should be valid and good information. So SSRIs, right? There are many different types of them. Fluoxetine, which is called Prozac, sertraline, which is called Zoloft, citalopram, which is called Celexa, and escitalopram, Lexapro, like I just talked about. And the name stands for selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors. So as that name suggests, primarily this targets serotonin. Serotonin is a neurotransmitter in your brain, and it helps brain cells communicate. And serotonin in particular is involved with mood, emotional regulation, sleep, appetite, and pain perception. So in mental health, low serotonin activity is linked to depression and anxiety. So the way SSRI medications work is they essentially help increase the amount of serotonin that's available to your brain in the space between neurons, which is called the synapse, basically just the space in between the things. And a neurotransmitter, like chemical messenger, needs to go through the synapse to get from one neuron to another. So typically with serotonin, it goes and it binds to another neuron, and then after that, it's sort of sucked back up and recycled into the body. And this prevents that process from happening, so instead it drifts around and it's more available to bind to other serotonin receptors. And therefore, that gives you some relief from depression or anxiety. Over time, it builds and builds and builds. You don't necessarily get the full effect of it right away. Usually, it takes several weeks to a month to, allow that change to happen in your brain. But then you get results. SSRIs are widely considered to be a first-line treatment for both depression and anxiety. And the clinical research, including randomized controlled trials, which is the highest level we have available, and meta-analyses, where we look at large swaths of data across multiple studies and aggregate them, they consistently show that they can reduce symptoms of depression and anxiety when compared to placebo, which would be like a sugar pill. And this is especially effective when you combine it with therapy and other sort of interventions like exercise, working on your diet, improving your lifestyle, all of that stuff. And SSRIs are very popular because their side effect profiles are typically pretty well tolerated. So now that you know how SSRIs work in general, how do they impact cognitive abilities? In the field of neurobiology, we say that there's no such thing as a free lunch, right? When you have a medication that causes a primary effect, you almost always have some other effects as well. These are called side effects. And they're not all bad. Not all side effects are evil. Sometimes we actually use medications specifically for their side effects. For example, a lot of people use SSRIs like escitalopram as a off-label treatment, meaning it's not the main effect, but the side effect you're using, for premature ejaculation. It actually helps reduce that. And you may see it even advertised by companies like Hims, where they have, you know, pills that they're selling to you. And it's just an antidepressant that has that side effect that's desirable to some people for that reason. It's an effect that some people don't like, and for others, it's beneficial. So what are the effects of SSRIs on cognition, on our thinking abilities? The answer here is not simple and clear-cut. Various clinical experiments have shown that a single dose of an SSRI can produce subtle but measurable cognitive changes. So it can change the way that you think. However, they seem to improve certain skills. So for example, inhibitory control. So if you are doing a task that requires careful attention and you need to not respond to certain things and actually respond to other things, imagine like you're working on an assembly line and you have to pull out products that are defective but not pull out ones that are fine. That would be inhibition, controlling the desire to, you know, automatically grab something. SSRIs seem to actually improve that type of skill. And others actually weaken a bit. So things like multitasking, trying to manage more than one thing at a time, or what we call set shifting, kind of alternating between tasks very fluidly. Those things tend to reduce with SSRIs, again, even in a single dose. And then there are others that are not impacted at all. So these studies suggest that increased serotonin can impact cognitive abilities, but they're not likely to cause broad deficits. They're going to cause a sort of shifting of your cognitive profile. Now, what about the long-term effects? The data here, I'm going to say, are reassuring. So in people without underlying cognitive disorders, meaning you don't have, say, Down syndrome, or you don't have really severe ADHD or some history of a brain injury, the research shows basically minimal impairment on cognitive testing when you're actually looking at the testing of somebody's abilities for those that are using SSRIs over a long period of time. One study, for example, looked at the performance of people that have been on 20 milligrams of Lexapro or escitalopram for 3 to 6 weeks versus a placebo group, and on cognitive tasks that involved little to no emotional component. So things like memorizing a list of words, doing a basic attention task, or basic executive functioning tasks like multitasking, there were no significant differences. And that was in 2023. Now, that's different from what people experience on SSRIs, what they feel like. We're talking about the difference between somebody's performance on cognitive testing when you actually do it in a rigorous, standardized way versus the subjective experience of what they're feeling. So despite the normal performance on cognitive tests, some participants still report subjective cognitive difficulties. Often they describe it as brain fog. One study looked at 67 patients that had been treated with SSRIs for over 6 months, and over 20% of them reported symptoms like poor concentration, mental fatigue, and forgetfulness. And aside from the brain fog, some people experience a feeling of emotional blunting or numbness, but these effects aren't universal. Some people tolerate it really well, others not so much. But again, there's this difference between the subjective feeling of being on an SSRI and what's actually measurable in studies. So for your own self, you can definitely make those judgment calls if you don't like how you feel, totally valid. But you may also be potentially overinterpreting the amount of impairment that's there. And it's certainly not a call to stop taking that because you're drastically impaired. Chances are, given this research, you're going to be about similar to other people, even that aren't on the medication. Now, in my line of work, as I said, I work with a lot of people who are concerned about memory problems and a lot of people who may be developing dementia. So there's actually been a great deal of research about SSRIs and dementia. Interestingly, there are actually several potential positive side effects from SSRIs when it comes to dementia, because they have downstream effects. So for example, SSRIs appear to produce more neuroplasticity, that is your brain's ability to sort of change and reorganize networks, and also more protective of neurons themselves. And this is thought to be because brain-derived neurotrophic factor, or BDNF. This is a protein that plays a main role in survival and functioning and the growth of neurons in the brain. And it also contributes to neuroplasticity and the formation of new neurons. And since SSRIs produce that in a sort of downstream way, it could be actually protective of your brain's neurons. In animal models of Alzheimer's disease, which is the most common cause of dementia in older adults, multiple SSRIs have demonstrated the ability to reduce amyloid beta plaques and tau tangles, which are abnormal protein buildups that contribute to the development of Alzheimer's disease. So that's pretty interesting. One SSRI, fluoxetine, was shown to increase the volume of the hippocampus as well, which is the part of the brain that's responsible for memory. And this is also activated by BDNF, that brain-derived neurotrophic factor signaling. So interesting stuff here. We also know that SSRIs have demonstrated anti-inflammatory effects in the brain because they affect certain cytokines, which are small proteins involved in the immune response. And this is thought to, when unchecked, contribute to degeneration of neurons. And so when you improve that, it may prevent some of that decline and that degeneration. So all of this suggests that SSRIs may have a neuroprotective effect and might slow the degenerative process in the brain. Now, when it comes to dementia, there are also some potential negative mechanisms that could increase somebody's risk. The most plausible mechanism for this would be through what's called anticholinergic activity. So that's involving acetylcholine, which is another neurotransmitter. That one plays a role in memory, learning, attention, but also muscle movement. So certain medications like antihistamines, muscle relaxers, and then of course some antidepressants and other mental health medications can lower acetylcholine. So for something like medication for an overactive bladder, this is the primary effect. We want to reduce the muscle tension of that bladder. But reduced acetylcholine is something that we don't want necessarily in a antidepressant, or it's simply a side effect that isn't intended along with the other stuff. Problem is, for older adults, that exposure to anticholinergic medications over time, that has been demonstrated to cause confusion, memory issues, drowsiness, and increased risk of falls. Cumulative exposure, so especially from multiple different medications, is also linked to a higher risk of dementia. So to be clear, most SSRIs, the medications we're talking about, those have minimal anticholinergic effects, and they wouldn't be very likely to cause these side effects. But there is one, paroxetine or Paxil, that's commonly prescribed. It's an SSRI as well, and that has been shown to have a significant anticholinergic effect. So that one should be used with caution. There are definitely circumstances where you might want to use that, but you of course need to weigh it with everything else. And there are also older forms of antidepressants like tricyclics that have known anticholinergic effects. Again, just something to be aware of and watch out for. These are often avoided, if possible, in older adults. For younger people, usually less of an issue. There have also been some studies on dementia. So a large study from the Netherlands that ran from 2018 to 2024, this followed about 5,500 dementia-free older adults for up to 16 years. The investigators compared participants who had used antidepressants to those who never did, and after adjusting for potential confounding factors, use of any antidepressants, so not just SSRIs, but any of them, was not associated with a higher risk of developing dementia. They also found no evidence of accelerated brain atrophy when they actually did MRI imaging of the brain for SSRI users versus non-users. So very reassuring there, and that's a 2024 study. On the other hand, there have been some observational studies that have demonstrated associations between SSRI use and cognitive decline in certain specific circumstances. So for example, one 2023 study compared older adults with depression who use antidepressants versus psychotherapy alone. Over a two-year follow-up, the antidepressant group showed a small but statistically significant increase in rates of newly diagnosed dementia as compared to the therapy group. However, this is correlational, and we know correlation does not imply causation, and it's a retrospective study, so there are potential confounding factors. For example, those with more severe functional impairments from their depression may have been more likely to seek out antidepressants, and these same personal factors may also contribute to an increased risk of developing dementia. One thing that I want to also point out that isn't exactly asked in that question, but it's important to highlight, is the consequences of untreated depression, because that's also something that you need to measure against everything else. Untreated depression can significantly impact memory and other cognitive functions. It can even mimic dementia, which is a condition we call pseudo-dementia. In particular, we've seen that working memory, attention, processing speed, memory retrieval, these can all be impacted by depression. And physically, depression has been linked to reduced size of brain structures that are essential in memory. The good news is that when depression is effectively treated or it resolves on its own, the cognitive symptoms also improve. One episode of depression is unlikely to cause persistent changes in someone's cognitive abilities. However, chronic untreated depression over time does appear to be a risk factor in degenerative diseases like dementia. So, in wrapping all this up, it's totally normal to be concerned about how medications might impact your cognitive abilities or your risk of developing dementia later in life. In fact, it's a good thing to consider your overall health profile and make informed choices that align with your personal goals and your needs. Like most things in medicine, it's about balance. Untreated depression itself is a risk factor, and it can lead people to self-medicate in risky ways or disengage from life in ways that increase overall health risks. In that context, the potential risks of a medication often pale in comparison to the risks of leaving depression untreated. When we look at the research, this is what stands out. Short-term use of SSRIs may cause subtle cognitive shifts, some positive, some negative, but not broad deficits. Long-term SSRI use does not appear to impair cognitive functioning based on objective testing. In older adults, SSRIs may provide some neuroprotective effects, and the concerns about increased dementia risk are largely based on either correlational or just poor studies overall. Not all antidepressants are the same. Paroxetine, for example, has a stronger anticholinergic effect and should be typically avoided in older adults. So overall, SSRIs are generally safe and well-tolerated, even when it comes to memory and cognitive health. For most people, untreated depression is really the more risky thing there. If you're on antidepressants or you're considering taking them, it's worth it to have an open conversation with your doctor about the risks and benefits and how those align with you as an individual. But generally speaking, pretty safe. So hopefully that answers some questions for you. Thank you so much for watching or listening. If you enjoyed this, please drop a like to help my mental health and brain-related content reach more people in the algorithm. Take care.